The sandwich tastes fantastic, and the milk after it is even better. I start to pour a second glass when I hear Dad's voice. I'm at the study door, then I glide into the room, my feet leaving tracks in the soft pile of the carpet. Dad has his back to me, still wearing his overcoat. He's talking to Mom. I know that, Em, but you've got to cancel, right? Yes, very upset. Exactly. No, not a clue, really. All we can do is be here and do whatever we can. I know, but he really does need us, both of us. Good. We can pick up something special on the way back. Maybe some steaks. Okay, I'm on my way. The north door, right? See you soon. He hangs up and walks past me out into the living room, headed for the front door. I hurry out, go the other way, through the kitchen and up the back stairs. Hey, Bobby, he's calling from the front hall. I'm outside my door. What? I keep some anger in my voice. I've got to run over and pick up Mom, then we'll be back and we can talk, and then maybe cook up some supper together, okay? Whatever. See you in about 20 minutes? Yup. Then the front door opens and closes, and the car starts outside, and then it's quiet. Back down in the kitchen, I finish pouring my glass of milk, grab the Oreos from the pantry, and walk to the TV room. The couch is cold, brown leather, so I wrap myself up in a fleece blanket before I sit down and punch the remote. It's Gilligan's Island on Channel 9. On Gilligan's Island, everything is safe and predictable. The professor is being smart, and Gilligan is being stupid. It's so comforting. The cookies and milk have filled me up, and the fleece blanket is warm, and the couch is comfy. I don't know why the skipper has to talk so loud. He's practically shouting, and he's wearing a green sport coat. Because it's not the skipper. I've been asleep for almost 2 hours. Good evening, and welcome to the WGN News at 6. We have a breaking story from Juliet Connors and the WGN Chicago road crew live at the scene. Juliet? The camera's not very steady, and my eyes are half open. The reporter is wearing a yellow parka with the hood down. She's trying not to squint into the bright lights. Her breath is a white cloud in the cold air. Tom, I'm here in Hyde Park, where there's been a three-car accident. The driver of this Jeep Cherokee apparently did not see the red light at this busy intersection near the University of Chicago. He is in police custody. Although he has not been charged at this time, this Ford Taurus was struck by the Jeep and then apparently spun around and was hit again by a third car. As you can see, the Taurus has been pushed up onto the sidewalk by the force of the multiple impacts. 10 seconds ago I was asleep, arguing with the skipper and Mary Ann about what to have for dinner. Now I'm sitting up, staring at the TV. I'm having a hard time breathing. The reporter keeps talking. The driver of the third car was not hurt, but both the driver and the passenger in the Taurus had to be removed by ambulance. At this hour, they are reported in serious condition at Presbyterian St. Luke's. This is Juliet Connors, and we'll be back later in the hour with a live update from the WGN road crew. I'm having a hard time breathing because of the car. The Ford Taurus on the TV, it's our car.